Last time on MasterChef.
Bring it on, cowboys.
The home cooks saddled up to feed a horde of hungry cowboys.
Hurry up, hurry up. We're killing it with these steaks.
That's good.
Katrina's blue team galloped to victory while in the pressure test.
He is agitated.
Stephen and Christopher rode their luck.
It's too close to call. You're both going up the balcony.
Holy. We're both safe. What a day.
Tonight.
You were going to be serving dinner in the MasterChef restaurant.
The top 10 team up to cook family style.
What are we feeding Gordon Ramsay's children? Stress.
Relationships will be put to the test.
Chris, that's our dessert. Get him in.
The chicken's in.
There's no way that we're going to get anything from the red team.
This is ridiculous, man.
All ending in the biggest shock of the season.
This is one family. You do not want to let down. Guys, come on down.
You know, this is a tough thing. To be top 10 is very important to me. My girlfriend really inspired me to take the plunge and leave everything behind, and here I am. But being here, I'm going to miss our 7-year anniversary. So it's tough for me, you know?
Tonight, you 10 home cooks will be split into 2 teams of 5. Each team's going to be responsible for making a delicious family dinner. An entree, 2 sides, and a dessert, all served family style. In one of America's best restaurants. This one right here. That's right, you are going to be serving dinner tonight in the MasterChef restaurant.
Tonight's meal is going to be very special. You will be creating treasured memories for a family that I have invited here tonight. This is one family that you do not want to let down.
It could be Gordon Ramsay's family, it could be previous MasterChef contestants, but for all I know, it could be the Kardashians.
Is it Prince William and Kate Middleton?
Are you all ready to find out your teams?
Yes. Yes!
Some of you haven't been team captains yet. And tonight, we are going to decide who those 2 team captains will be.
The first team captain will be captain of the blue team, Derek. Second team captain of the red team is Claudia.
All right, Derek, Claudia, please come up here and put on your captain's aprons. Good job.
Alicia.
Thank you.
This is gonna sound cocky, but it's about time I'm team captain. I've been listening and watching over this entire competition. I know everyone's strengths.
Right, Derek, you've got the first pick.
First pick? Nick.
Don't forget your blue apron. Good.
This is family style. I have an Italian family background, and so does Nick. Simple pick.
Claudia.
My first pick is somebody that has amazing flavor profiles, and I have seen their tenacious attitude. I pick Katrina.
Katrina, wow. Katrina, please. Derek, second pick.
My next pick is Olivia.
Yeah. I actually would prefer to be on Claudia's team, because we don't butt heads. Derek and I definitely butt heads.
My second pick is Hethel.
Yeah. Hethel. Interesting. Next pick.
All differences aside, my next pick is Chris.
Wow. What a third pick.
There's no one that I know that understands vegetables more than Steven.
Wow. Steven, come on up. Derek, you're picking for both teams now.
This person is overlooked a lot. Tommy.
Wow, Tommy.
Jeff.
Welcome to the red team, baby. I haven't been overconfident, like perhaps Derek has, but the truth is, I am methodical, strategic, and delegate a lot in my regular job as an event manager, so I think that we will have no problem getting this win.
Each team will have just 90 minutes to prep and cook an entree, 2 sides, and an incredible dessert. In the pantry, you will find everything you could possibly imagine to make your family dinner. Remember what's at stake. The winning team will be safe from elimination, and the losing team will face another challenge, after which at least one of you might be seeing your own families quicker than you had hoped.
Your time starts
Everybody take a book.
I'm thinking, honestly, family dinners. I mean, what better than chicken?
Yes.
How are you feeling about
chicken? Yeah, roasted chicken.
Perfect. So what do we think about sides?
Mashed potatoes or
potato
au gratin.
Mashed potatoes, I think, are real genius. Yeah. And then you could do broccolini with Asiago cheese shavings on top.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not sure what you're thinking for a dessert.
Strawberry shortcake?
Oh, that sounds delicious.
With whipped cream.
I'm Italian rooted. You're Italian rooted. Let's go. We're going to go Italian. So we're going to do a lamb rack.
Hell yeah.
I want to do a caprese salad. And Nick, your baked ziti with that amazing grandmother sauce.
You got to do it.
Does that go well with the caprese? I think it does.
I think it goes amazing. Absolutely. And then we're going with a chocolate mousse pie. You do a great crust. Yeah. Super simple. It's going to be beautiful.
Blue tea!
I got tons of garlic. Yes.
Do it, guys.
Let's go. One stunning family-style entree followed by a delicious family-style dessert. Let's go.
Wow. Family style cooking.
So excited.
You learn to fall in love with food first and foremost at home at the dinner table, and then it's how you learn how to cook, right? Yeah. Really curious to see what dishes they put together.
How are you doing there, Steven?
Great.
Let's just communicate, guys, okay?
Yep.
I trust you all.
Eye on the prize.
You got it, pal.
Yes, chef.
Backing you up, Derek.
Thanks, Tommy.
We've seen great home cooks with great potential completely crumble under the pressure of being team captain.
Yeah.
Do you know how to trust?
Yeah, you're gonna help me trust.
Perfect, I'll trust for you.
65 minutes to go. Speed up, guys.
I need crusts rolled out.
Can I have 3 minutes?
I'll give you five.
Okay, awesome.
Can you move a little faster, babe?
Yep.
Right, Claudia.
Yes, chef.
Describe the menu, please.
Yes, chef. We're making a herb-roasted whole chicken today with a garlic mashed potato and sautéed broccolini with a strawberry shortcake for dessert.
Cool, done.
Now, whole chickens averaging 22, 23 minutes per pound, 3.5-pound birds. That's a minimum of an hour in the oven roasting. How are you going to cook them in time?
We're going to get them right in the oven right away, chef.
I just want to make sure that your chicken, for a very important family that's dear to my heart,
yes, chef.
Doesn't go out undercooked.
I think we should split them. We're going to split the chickens right now. We're going to split them in half.
Is that your decision or the captain's decision?
It's going to be the captain's decision. Captain, do you think we should split the chickens in half, lay them flat like this? They're going to cook in half the time?
I think that's
smart. By all means, yeah, let's do it.
Let's do it. We can still keep them juicy.
Sure, let's do it.
Okay, captain's decision.
Red team, get organized, please. Okay.
Understood, chef.
Thank you.
Of course. We got to get these in the next 5 minutes, guys.
All right. Derek.
Yes, chef.
What are you making for dinner?
So we're doing Italian family style. I'm playing to the strong suits that everyone has. I'm going with lamb because I nailed it in my white apron battle. Olivia is going to be doing the caprese salad. Nick's strong suit is Italian. So we're doing a baked ziti and a chocolate mousse pie. Simple.
Good luck.
Thank you.
We are halfway there. Just under 45 minutes to go.
Chris, how those pies doing, dude?
Going.
Chris, I need that in the oven so fast.
I know.
Right, blue team, how are we doing?
Blue team, Derek's doing good. He seems in control, but the menu doesn't sound as cohesive as I thought it was.
Ready, what are we doing?
They have a caprese salad, but then they also have a baked ziti, and then they have a lamb rack.
Why would you put two cheeses on the sides?
I think in their mind, these are the dishes that they feel the most comfortable with cooking and finessing from an Italian standpoint.
Right, so it's two pieces of tomato per piece of cheese.
Is anybody looking at it on a family table?
No.
I mean, this is crazy.
Mm-hmm. No one stepped back and seen the big picture.
Ooh, yummy.
How are we doing? We need to get these in the oven.
I've got even more disturbing news. The red team. The chickens are now being halved, but they're still not in the oven.
What are they waiting for?
They should have cooked half an hour ago.
Can we get these chickens in? Can we at least
No, not yet. Why can't we get them in?
Because they're not dry.
Claudia, I've done this millions of times.
So have I, babe.
There's no way that those chickens are going to get cooked in time.
We need to get the chickens in now.
Red team,
yes.
You've got to get your chickens
in
the oven.
Get the chickens
in. Get them in.
I'm putting the chicken in.
No.
How do you want to do it?
Yes.
What do you guys want me to do with the chicken? Let me
start. Nothing. You stay.
Wow.
There's no way that we're going to get anything from the red team.
This is ridiculous, man.
We are halfway there. Just under 45 minutes to go.
We need to get the chickens in now.
Red team.
Yes.
You've got to get your chickens
in
the oven.
Get the chickens in.
Get them in.
I'm putting the chicken in.
These clucking chickens have to get in the oven right now. We're going to see raw meat.
There's no way that those chickens are going to get cooked in time.
I got it. I'll put it in. It doesn't take all of us to set an oven.
You serve a bloody raw bird to anybody's family, you go home. Or they'll kick you out your own house. Done. All I know is Claudia needs to pull this ship together. because we will all go down.
What if we feed Gordon Ramsay's children?
My goodness. Stress.
Blue team.
Yes, Chef.
Are
yes,
on
Chef.
It?
Yes.
Have you thought about this menu, Derek, collectively sat on the table?
Yes.
We've got two cheese and tomato sides.
Yes.
Baked ziti with cheese and a tomato mozzarella salad.
I think that the marriage of the tomatoes is
okay.
the combining
factor. Well, I get that, but yeah. I'm just trying to point out a fact to help you.
Yes.
Not serve the same dish twice. I've got a very important family, Derek.
Yes, I understand.
And it means they've travelled, Derek. They've travelled thousands of miles to be here.
Yes, yes,
you can change and you can alternate. I'm just trying to get you successful.
I understand.
Good, let's go. Are the chickens in?
Yes, Chef, they're in.
Thank goodness for that.
All of them.
Okay.
Okay.
Solution time. I think we should do a strawberry and tomato and arugula salad. It basically, it's like rice and sweet, and then this is like heavy and cheesy.
Yeah, I like it.
I know you get tomato and strawberry.
Okay.
Do you feel that?
Yeah. Okay, we gotta change the salad. Extra mozzarella, we got cheese in the baked ziti. I'm gonna have to trust Olivia that she can make it happen.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
Olivia, come take a quick look. It's gonna need a blind bake just a little bit more because it's so big. So it's
what happened? What's wrong with it?
No, nothing. It's just not, it needs a little bit more blind baking. That's all, we're good.
Just under 20 minutes to go, guys. Come on. Speed up, please.
Killing me.
No, it's fine, I swear.
If it's fine, then why are we opening it? Chris, you know what, man? I need you to make pie crust. Chris, you have one job. Pie crust. That is it. Pie crust. How is it?
Fine, let me just deflate this and I'll throw it in
the
chili.
No, it's not. No, put it back in. Ah, I'm like, I just need a pie crust. Go, go, go. We're losing heat in that oven.
No, give me a second. Please don't try to micromanage me. It just makes it worse. It shut down.
Yummy, yummy in my tummy.
I need to taste those mashed potatoes. These need more cream. They're not creamy enough.
Don't take them out, please. Okay.
I'm sorry. They need to have just a bit more butter.
Can you take care of it?
Yes, I can. Absolutely.
This is looking so amazing. I wish you could see it. You would die.
5 minutes to go. Come on.
You want to see something beautiful?
Oh, pretty girl.
Here it is.
Yeah.
Hi. I have to say, the blue team's baked ziti looks fantastic.
Looks awesome. On your left, careful.
That's our dessert?
Yeah.
You know, it looks terrible. Their chocolate mousse pie.
It's, oh, dear, oh, dear.
Oh, the cream.
2 minutes to go.
Just put them on there with whipped cream.
Captains, get your teams to victory.
Let's take an internal temperature.
Yeah. It's 169. Yeah. It's technically done.
The chickens are not out in the tray yet.
Oh, my God. Even the chicken.
It's coming.
The family are seated. We are less than 60 seconds to go for the ultimate family dinner. Hurry up.
Let's go. Buzz it up.
Oh, my goodness me.
Watch out. One easy. Watch out. Chris, watch out. Move.
I'm moving.
Yeah, stop yelling. Get the out of the way.
Yes, hurry up. Hurry.
Last 30 seconds.
I need your help here.
What can I do?
Hey, look out. Let me wipe off this.
Nick, help me organize this.
Go.
It's falling on me.
Pour the gravy, guys. Pour the gravy. Get that gravy on.
Now. Bring it to me now.
Come on.
Start wiping this plate.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
Give me a towel.
4, 3, 2, 1, and stop. Hands in the air. Walk away from your plating station, please. Thank you, servers.
As a team, we went above and beyond a typical family meal. The lamb is cooked perfectly. The baked ziti is cooked perfectly. But I'm looking at the pie, and I hate it. And that's the last thing they're going to think about when they vote. This could sink our ship. We could go down on dessert.
Red team, blue team, once the family have eaten, they will then decide on which dinner they preferred. The winning team will be safe, and the losing team will, of course, as always, face the dreaded pressure test. Thank you. Get out of here.
I'm really hoping that the love that we put into this meal really shines through for this family, whoever the family is.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Seriously, thank you so much for coming. Trust me. We are honored to have you all here, and they out there have no idea that you are the family that we have invited. So they are in for a shock, let me tell you. Right now, out there are the 10 best home cooks in all of America. And luckily for you, they are your loved ones.
Derek's mom, Stacy. You had no clue that Derek was even auditioning for MasterChef. When did you last see Derek?
About a year ago. And the last time I did see him, he surprised me. So this is going to be a real twist.
Ta-ta. Gorgeous princess. On a scale of 1 to 10, how much are you missing Mum?
Can I go above 10?
Yeah, of course you can.
Like 100.
100. Wow. Stephen's son, Stephen Jr.
Hi.
Did you know that Dad was that much of a cook?
No. I mean, his food was good, but I liked hanging out with him. Mm-hmm. He's cool dad. And it's been hard for me not to have him around.
Aww. And does he shout at you a lot, the way he shouts at me?
He has those short spasms of energy, yes.
Uh-oh.
Here we go.
Your dinner tonight has been prepared by two teams of five. You guys are each going to receive an entree and a dessert from each of the teams. After that, without knowing who cooked what or what team your loved one was on, you're going to judge on which meal overall that you preferred.
Painful.
The Blue Team have done an amazing roast, a rack of lamb served with some olive tomatoes and a baked ziti. And on the side is a strawberry rocket salad finished with a chocolate mousse pie. And the red team?
Yeah, the red team has done a roasted chicken, rustic garlic mashed potato, and then we also have some broccolini with Asiago cheese, and then we also have strawberry shortcake.
Oh boy, this is gonna be tough.
I know.
Bon appetit, please. Enjoy.
Yay, here we go.
That lamb had a perfect crust on it.
Yeah, it looked good.
The cheese was perfectly crisp on the ziti.
Boy, that lamb turned out great. So tender.
I love lamb.
I think that the lamb is lacking in like a lot of
seasoning.
Yeah.
I thought so too. Under seasoned.
Although the pasta from the Blue Table is very good.
Yeah.
The salad dressing is amazing.
The Blue Team, I think their ziti is misplaced.
I do too.
I think
that's
what
I'm having trouble with. Although I like it.
I just don't think that the ziti. Yeah.
It's not right with the whole thing.
All right, okay, I'm gonna try time this for one. The chicken. Here we go.
That was an awesome job, Stephen. Best idea today was to split those chickens down the middle and get them opened up.
So
like
I'm talking
way.
To my brother?
Yes.
So good.
So good. Stephen Jr., so far, what's been your favorite?
Red.
Red?
Alex.
Yeah.
Katrina's boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
Where are you leaning entree-wise?
Oh, boy, it's tough. I can put everything together into, like, a perfect bite with mm-hmm. the red plate. I can't necessarily do that with the blue plate, but I will say that I love everything that's on the blue plate. So I guess I'm leaning towards the blue.
Interesting.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, are we ready to tuck into those delicious desserts from the red team and the blue team?
Yes!
Yes.
Oh, my God. I know, right?
The only thing I'm concerned about, and Chris, you know it, is 90 minutes on getting that crust. Almost 90 minutes.
Barbara, Nick's mom, where are you leaning?
I am leaning towards the red plate. I think the pound cake is really very good. It's a nice balance. The problem with me with the blue plate is I think the crust is not quite right. My son probably made it, and he's going to kill me, but I'm sorry.
Jenny, Christopher's girlfriend.
I actually preferred the blue plate. I felt like the red plate was a little heavy, a little denser than I would like, and the blue plate was lighter. And I actually like the bitterness of the dark chocolate.
Thank you all for that incredible feedback.
We would like to invite you to make your vote. If you like the red team's food best, you'll keep the red card in the checkbook. If you like the blue team's dinner the best, you'll leave the blue team's card.
Love the suspense.
Let's go see who it is.
Please welcome the best 10 home cooks in all of America.
My mom gave up a lot to raise me, and she didn't get to fulfill her dreams. She taught me that I could. And so
I'm here to make a dream come true and win MasterChef.
Did you know it? Did you know?
I'm so, so proud of you.
Oh.
I'm not crying. Her tears came onto my face.
Come on, I'm crying too.
Steven, someone very special here to see you.
Come on, look at me. Oh, I love you. Oh.
I love you so much.
You look so good, babe. I miss you so much.
For a long time, it was just me and my mom. Literally exactly how it is with me and my daughter right now. She is someone that has taught me everything that I know about food. This is one of the most important families. This is the top 10s family. I can't believe I just cooked for my mom.
Red team, blue team, well done. You okay, bud?
I'm okay. Yeah.
You sure?
Oh, yeah.
Tomorrow we're going to cook for your family, okay? Yeah. Okay. Oh, God. What's the matter with that?
Come on. You know, I'm a sensitive man.
Sorry. Big deep breath. You can do it. Come on.
All right.
Okay. Now, you really need to understand tonight that your loved ones had no idea who cooked what. And all of their votes had been cast. I love you.
I love you.
We're going to start with Claudia's mum, Julia. Will you reveal which dinner you preferred? Was it from the red team or the blue team? Red team. Claudia, relieved?
Oh, yeah, chef.
Now, young lady, no pressure. Please reveal red or blue team.
Up top, baby.
Yeah! Roger, open your checkbook and reveal which dinner you preferred.
Oh, blue
I'm
team.
In, Roger.
Yeah. Yeah.
Blue, 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 blue. Yeah.
Jenny, what's in your checkbook? Roots. Eileen. The chocolate bar.
Oh, my goodness.
Same.
It is 3 to the red, 3 to the blue team. Alex.
Come on, Alex. I love you, buddy.
Oh, I'm so sorry, babe.
Alex, that's the first vote that's gone against their family loved one. Stephen Jr., reveal which dinner you prefer this evening.
You're one lucky boy. Yeah.
We are even again. Barbara.
Come on, Ma.
It was chicken.
I know it was chicken. And right when I saw you, I was like, damn it.
It is now 5 votes to the red team and 4 to the blue team. Stacey. Reveal, red or blue? It is now 5 votes to the red team and 4 to the blue team. Stacey, if you've decided blue, then it's a tie. If it's red, it's over. Reveal, yeah. Red or blue? Red team!
Mom, thank you for coming to MasterChef. I'm so glad you're here. I'm just so bummed you picked the wrong dish.
Blue team, unfortunately, tomorrow night you will face another challenge where at the end of it, at least one of you, sadly, will leave the competition. But tonight, please, all of you, enjoy the rest of the night together. If you go further in this competition, clearly it's going to be some time before you see each other again.
Yes.
Well done. Thank you. Good night.
Thank you guys so much.
Thank you so much.
Oh, wow.
My God, that was tough.
Yes, thank you so much, Champagne.
Oh, yes.
Woohoo! Here's you, man.
I'm so proud.
Oh, my God.
It's
so
different. Your hair's so long.
How'd your theater go?
Oh, really good. It was the best play I've ever done.
Really? That's awesome.
So we get to hang out?
We do.
All night.
No.
Welcome, guys.
I've got the black apron on, and it's really tough going into this pressure test because I felt like I did so well as a captain. I don't know where this is going. I'm just not ready to go home.
Now, there are five of you standing in front of us, but not all of you are going to have to face tonight's dreaded pressure test. Only four of you are. And that person who we want to save is your team captain, Derek. You were let down in the dessert department, but the lamb dish works. It looks stunning.
Thank you.
So take your apron off, head up to the balcony.
Thank you.
I am so glad I'm safe from this one because my parting words to my mom is, I'll see you when I'm MasterChef winner. So if I went home in this pressure test, my mom would never forgive herself.
This dish that you are about to face takes the humble potato and turns it into something elegant, something served at the finest restaurants. Gnocchi. Potatoey pillows of perfection.
Yeah, buddy.
Being Italian, some people call me Nicky Gnocchi. I mean, I've been rolling gnocchi out with my grandmother since I could see over the counter. I can make gnocchi in my sleep, baby. Bring it on. Let's go.
All of you, it's time to head to your stations.
It's so important for me to survive this pressure test. Winning MasterChef would allow me to better provide for my girlfriend. I want to give her the dream wedding that she deserves.
On your stations, you'll find everything you need to make us this dish. You have one baked potato, eggs, butter, flour, salt, pepper, and sage.
You will each have 25 minutes. That's right, just 25 minutes to make us a delicious gnocchi dish finished in a sage brown butter sauce.
Your 25 minutes start now.
Now, gnocchi. So this is all about the feel and the texture.
The beautiful part about a perfect gnocchi dish is simplicity, right? But so many things could go wrong. Where do you think these home cooks will struggle?
Lumpy potatoes to begin with, so therefore they haven't riced them properly. Too much flour, so it just tastes gummy.
That's what I'm afraid of. Yeah, it can get too dense.
So the less you roll it, the more fluffy it's going to get.
Liv, that looks great. Don't work it too much, though.
Just coming up to 10 minutes gone. Just over 15 minutes to go. Right, Nick, how are you feeling?
I feel great. Gnocchi and I go way back.
What's going to separate your gnocchi from everybody else?
You got to keep it light, pillow.
Confident you can get through this one and hit the top nine?
Yes, Chef, absolutely. Top nine's calling my name.
Good luck.
Thank you, Chef.
All right, Christopher, you got your first batch into your boiling water a little bit longer than a typical blanch on the gnocchi.
You got to trust the gnocchi and let it float, and I was waiting for it to float.
Okay. Make sure those gnocchi have a nice, even, golden brown color on every side. Remember, it's all about the seasoning.
Copy that, Chef.
Good luck.
Thank you, Chef.
Hi, Chef.
Hi, Olivia. Hey, what's going on?
I've only made gnocchi one time before.
The only thing I would say is that, remember, you have your brown butter, which is going to be the little finishing drip. Mm-hmm. So something like this, look at them, they're starting to look a little greasy. So take those, dab them on a paper towel, then go back and gently place them somewhere.
Okay, thank you.
Just under 8 minutes to go.
Come
a lot of stuff going on out there, huh?
Slightly concerned about Christopher.
Yeah, well, I have to say, Christopher blanches gnocchi for about two and a half minutes, which is not a blanch.
Right.
That's nearly a boil.
Yeah.
I'm concerned about Nick only because he still has 6 minutes to go and he's plated his dish.
I think he's that confident, Christina.
Yeah, buddy.
I don't like the texture of these. They don't look the way that I want. My gnocchi is exploding and they look like snot.
Oh, Tom.
2 minutes to go.
I've got extra gnocchi dough, so I immediately chop, 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 and throw them in that box.
Look at breaking news right now. Tommy is redoing it all. He's making a new batch of gnocchi.
Wow.
With just minutes to go.
Is that even possible?
Hurry, Tommy.
I know. The clock is ticking down.
Coming up to 90 seconds.
Oh, boy. I'm starting to sweat like James Brown.
It's going to be tight.
If this second batch fails, I'm just going to be dead in the kitchen.
Look at breaking news right now. Tommy is redoing it all. He's making a new batch of gnocchi.
Wow.
With just minutes to go.
Is that even possible?
Hurry, Tommy.
I know.
Coming up to 90 seconds.
Flowing, Tommy. It's flowing.
Don't get it out of there.
Let's go. Come on, Tommy. Got the plate.
Oh, my gosh. Tommy just poured all of his brown butter sauce on the plate.
You got too much butter.
They need to be down on the front veg. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and stop. Hands in the air, guys. Right, it's time to taste your gnocchi and to see how you did. Right, Nick, describe your dish.
I made a classic potato gnocchi in a sage brown butter sauce with fried sage leaves.
And ratio of potato to flour is what, please?
In the past, learning from my grandmother who taught me how to make gnocchi, I go by eye and really feel.
The plate smells incredible.
Thank you.
Wow. Crispy, light, seasoned beautifully. I want to dive back in there for more.
Thank you.
That's exactly the way to make gnocchi.
Absolutely.
Good job.
Thanks, Chef.
Incredible.
Thank you.
I mean, so light, so pillowy. Ratio of flour and egg to potato, spot on. I wish they were a little bit bigger.
Yeah.
What do you think your mom would have thought of this gnocchi?
My mom has never sugarcoated anything. She taught me to be my own hardest critic because the minute you let up, someone's going to pass you up and take over. So you always got to be pushing to be great.
Well, Nick, keep pushing.
I will.
It's clearly making a difference as you rise in this competition.
Thank you.
Hi, Olivia. I think you were the underdog here. You've only made it one time before.
Yeah.
But visually, I think yours is the most beautiful out of the four.
Thank you.
They're delicious. Great flavor. Yeah. Technique-wise, I think next to Nick's, pretty much neck and neck. I think the only thing is yours are a little larger. Not a lot that I would change to the dish. I think it's pretty beautiful. You should
Thank
be proud.
You.
Good job.
Thank you.
Just watching the way you work, it's almost like the more pressure we put you under, the better you get.
Thank you.
They look absolutely beautiful. I like them that size because you get more crisp on them.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Yeah, delicious. Nick's was there. Yours has gone beyond that. A touch more butter. It's not going to kill you. It's going to elevate a dish to on the verge of perfection. Great job.
Well done. Thank you. Woo!
Christopher. So first of all, I'm just disappointed in the presentation. From a brown butter sauce standpoint, typically you'll find the sauce on the outer edges of the plate so that when you're ready to dig into it, you pull it over rather than having it sit in that bed of brown butter sauce.
Top chef.
Take a bite. Your dumplings are definitely more on the under-seasoned side.
Okay.
The potato dumpling filling tastes a little dry.
Okay.
At least one person is going home. It's probably going to be between you and Tommy.
Okay.
Christopher, now, have you got a little ant infestation? What is all that stuff?
No, it's just a little bit of cracked black pepper. I thought it would just be, you know, nice presentation, and if you want a little bit of bite.
Rule number one, that chefs need to season things smartly and not allow the customer to season it. That's the whole idea.
Okay.
Well, anyway, the size.
So, Christopher, rolling your eyes to the balcony while Gordon's tasting your dish, just to be clear, when we say we see everything, we mean it. If you're going to be that disrespectful, why are you here? I can hold that back door open for you if you want. We don't even have to taste Tommy's dish.
The size.
So, Christopher, rolling your eyes to the balcony while Gordon's tasting your dish, when we say we see everything, we mean it. If you're going to be that disrespectful, why are you here? I can hold that back door open for you if you want. We don't even have to taste Tommy's dish. Don't be disrespectful.
Christopher does not get it. He has been chewed out multiple times by Christina, and here he is again. Dude, look who's standing in front of you.
Now, you've got a great color on there, a nice sear, but the big issue is it needs more seasoning. Season the dish, not the plate. It was interesting because I was watching you like a hawk. You didn't taste the mixture before you blanched it. And if you don't taste what you're about to start poaching, sauteing, how on earth are you expecting the end result to come out as a MasterChef quality dish? What a shame.
I'm really angry at myself that I didn't perform better, and I wish things went differently.
Right, Tommy. We were less than 2.5 minutes to go, and it looked like you started again.
Yes.
And now you've served them in a swimming pool of butter. Why so much butter on there?
Well, I guess it's my Jackson Pollock in me of not being able to hold back.
Bollocks.
I have to stop this.
Yeah, Jackson bollocks. Well, here's the weird thing. I mean, it looks like they've drowned, but they actually taste decent. The nut brown butter's there, the flavour's there. I don't get it with you, because you're just, you know, you've got the heart, but then you're clumsy.
Yes.
The deal is if you saw that, you see how mushy this is.
Yes.
It has nothing to do with the amount of sauce that you've put on the plate. It's simply the actual dough. I mean, they're all sticking together.
Yes. I made a mistake with my first batch. I tried to save myself from that.
Here's the issue I have. While Christopher has the color, presentation was obviously much, much nicer, but your flavor is on the money. It's almost as if I could mix the two of you and I'd have a solid dish.
Yes. Every muscle on my body is clutching. Every pore on my face is twitching. I hate to think it, but there's a real possibility that I could be going home today.
This elimination challenge, I think, really divided the kitchen into two teams. One pair gave us like a demonstration on how to perfect gnocchi. The other pair struggled under pressure.
Olivia and Nick, please step forward. The two of you put out great plates. You are both safe from elimination. Please head up to the balcony.
Thank you so much.
I expect to be number one. So making top nine is like, thank you, one step closer.
Christopher, tonight, let's be honest, that wasn't one of your strongest performances, you know that. It may have looked like you seared them properly, but the actual flavor was missing. Tommy, rule number one, when poaching gnocchi, you never put a lid on it. Then, with 3.5 minutes to go, you attempted to make the dish again. Then you destroyed it with seconds to go by flooding them. Tommy, say goodbye to Christopher. And head up to the balcony.
Let's go out last time. Be good, brother.
Christopher, after the top 10 in MasterChef, we're looking for intuitiveness. Tasting a mix is important. By not tasting it, showed us that you're just still not ready to become America's next MasterChef. I still strongly believe that you're walking through those doors a much, much, much better cook than you came in. Please, come and say goodbye.
Truly a pleasure. Thank you.
Likewise.
For everything.
Thank you
for the guidance. You're welcome. Thank you, Graham. Thank you, Chris.
Please, place your apron on your bench. Thank you.
You know, after the tasting, I'm feeling just a little disappointed. And I would have liked to move further, but I'm very proud of myself for making it as far as I did. So I came in here aspiring to one day become a restaurateur.
You've got a great sense of humor, and you light up the room.
Please, I did something right. My culinary knowledge has definitely grown.
There was one standout apple pie, Christopher.
I have newfound appreciation for cooking. There's some highs and lows.
No. It's my turn to talk. You wanted us to taste this?
Right behind. Excuse me. Right behind. Move.
Thank you, Chris. You're our rock star.
I never really believed myself. Yeah! But I'm leaving here as a pretty good home cook. Top 10.
Next week,
I'm going to show you how it's done.
Damn! I'm not the only thing flaming in this kitchen tonight.
The competition heats up as the final nine face a red-hot challenge.
You must be careful playing with fire.
Who will plate the hottest dishes of their lives?
Really delicious.
Boom. You just keep getting better and better.
And who will go down in flames?
That has just put you to the back.
One potato, two potato.